I'll be right back. I have to. I was gonna squirt the cat because the cat is being bad outside. Cat gets upset when everyone retreats to their room. All right, let's get to the fun slash hard part. His face. Let's see, what do we want to do with his face? You know what? I'm just gonna do this. I'm not going to match his face too much, obviously, since I have a tendency to make things cute. Let's see if I don't even know how to make this thing cute. All right. Let's see, what kind of mouth do I want to give him? I don't really like this mouth here. Oops. Let's see. I only have noses, so do something like this. All right, let's see if I can flesh this out a little bit. Bugs are so tough because they're really hard to anthropomorphize. It's really hard to make them look human because they don't have human features at all. What's up, Murden? Thanks for checking out the video. How you doing? How you feeling? Are you here from YouTube or from Instagram? They actually have really small eyes though, don't they? They kind of have like... little tiny dots, I believe. That looks kind of creepy though. And if I want to make, I don't know. I don't know if I want to make him cute or make his eyes more realistic. I don't know. see. I don't know. I don't know how I want to make his eyes. I'll just make him really big. Start these eyes again. Yeah, I know. I was thinking about, I probably could do the big pupils. No, and actually this photo is a bit, he kind of has like, I don't know if that's eyelids or if that's like, I don't know what that is. Kind of would be interesting to give him like weird eyelids there, but I might stick with the, I mean, you can't go wrong with big pupils, right? Let's see, do we want to do the low eyelids? Maybe I should try without the low eyelids. Let me just merge all this so I can, that was a bold choice to just go with the lower eyelids at first without playing around with it first, but we'll see. All right, so now we got the base. We have the base eyes. This one's super, super oval. I don't know, do we want to like, could we make him angry? Or we could make him like, something like that. Make him like super cool. Might look too, too angry there. Let's see. I could just start out bare bones and go happy. That's interesting. Let's see, let's do a quick test here. That's kind of interesting. wish I could really get more of the smile, though. I do like those big round eyes, but maybe I just need to go more simple in the mouth. Yeah, maybe something like that. Maybe something a little more. Looks weirder, right? Closed mouth smile. That's a good idea. Cause I'm getting a little crazy now. Maybe he just needs to have like a kawaii type smile. Like really small. Let's try on a layer above this. I gotta take off my sweatshirt. I'm burning up in here. And I'm gonna open a window, so I'll be right back. I apologize. Burning up. All right, I'm gonna clip this back on me. Okay, also, let me fix this. He's way off balance. Fix this eye a bit. Oops, that made the eye a little too small. Okay, so that's that. And I gotta fix, I don't know why this eye is so ugly, even for a sketch. Circle. Try to match the white space. All right, that's a little better. All right, let's try this closed mouth smile. That's a great suggestion. Do we want the smile to be down here? Could be down there. That's kind of nice. Or it could be like a kawaii type. It's kind of generic. could be something like that. You know what? Let me try one more eye, one more mouth, a couple more mouths maybe. I think I kind of like the lower. Let me switch brushes here. I like that mouth, but it doesn't look. I pictured it down low. I love watching my progression. Oh. Thank you. Yeah, it's kind of. It's like a fun process, and I figured, since I was going to be sketching it anyway, I might as well. Let's see. What if I just. Where would his cheeks go? That's the thing. I kind of like this mouth. Let me hold on to this. Let me hold on to this one. I know I could just draw it again, but it's more dramatic if I save it off to the side, I think. What if I made the mouth really low? Ooh, that's interesting. I just gave him a big eye thingies here. Do we like this to circles, or I don't know if we want the circles or we want the whole eye things. I kind of like the eye things, but I don't know. I don't know if we need them. Let's see here. Oh, that's a decent. That might. Oh, I don't even know if I need that though, because his eye is kind of round, so I don't know if I actually even need to. I do like this kind of shape though. It's more in line with how I draw my regular character's eyes. That's right, I like floating eyebrows. The only thing, I have to make sure it never looks like that clip art paper clip. That's the only thing that sometimes makes me, reminds me of floating eyebrows. Is that, I think it was like a Microsoft Word, floating eye, floating, I don't know what it was, mascot or whatever you want to call it. I don't know if, I mean, that was a long time ago that they had that thing. Was it Clippy? Is that his name? That thing is like, I feel old thinking about that. How did I make this? It's not bad. Right, let me just make sure I don't want the mouth to be. Less distinguished and more cute. We'll give him like two teeth. Two teeth always reads as cute to me. I have a thing for cute characters with two teeth. Kind of like, I don't know, reminds me of the Land Before Time, maybe? I feel like their little dinosaurs had two teeth. I don't know. Man, it's very different, though. It's very different from the reference. But I like it. Make it a little closer to the reference and not have it such a cone. I mean, that's a decent compromise. I guess I can give him a little chin, right? Since we're already giving him big pupils and teethies, I guess I can give him a little chin. They kind of do have like a round, I don't know if I want to give him a round nose, so to speak, but it might be a little much. He does have some like designs on his nose. I don't know how I want to tackle that yet. It might be good for now. All right, let me fix up this body a little bit. It's got his kind of neck area. This area kind of comes off the back. All right, let me fill out this face for you guys. Let me erase these circles. Since we don't need them right now. The sizes are a little off. This is a little, looks a little bigger, but that's okay. I'm not mad at that. It's not bad. So it looks like the other one. Nah. Gonna do it more simple. I can get down with that. Running out of canvas here. Alright. Alright, so we got his eye sockets. And yeah, I'm not gonna do these weird eyes because those are a little too, he would look a little too alienish if he had eyes like this. Very weird though, very interesting bugs. So we're just gonna do a, what should we do, what should we do? First of all, I'm gonna color it all gray. Because I always do that because I like adding white highlights. And even though I use tan paper, I don't know if you could tell, but the paper is not the paper. The background is not white. It's like, that would be white. See if you can see a difference. Yeah, that would be white, but I prefer tan. All right, so that's colored in. I'm gonna do it on a layer above, I think, because I'm terrible at drawing circles. I'm gonna use a circle assist. Just duplicate it. All right. The position of eyes is so difficult. I like it so often that I make my characters look so cockeyed. I guess I'm not sure why I used the red either. When I first started, I think it was just to be cool. And then it was like, I would use it when I, actually, I don't think I have my, let's see if I have a sketchbook here. That'd be really cool. My old sketchbook, but when I used to draw in my old sketchbook, I would actually draw in red color pencil because I could always do the black lines over it, and it just wouldn't be, I don't know, like, it's like, I remember when I used to draw in my sketches, I could draw in red. And if I wanted to bring it into a computer, I could just digitally get rid of all the red. So I think that was one of the reasons why I did it as well. And now, for some reason, I don't know, I really just like the way it looks. I've tried blue as well, but I really just like the way red looks. Since I don't really have to... I think I hear a cat outside. I'm gonna bring you guys with me to see if there's a cat outside. I'm not sure. Alright. Hopefully my battery doesn't die. Ugh. I don't see anything. I thought I heard some cats. Oh, look who's hungry. Okay. All right, let me get my trusty headlamp. This is gonna be so embarrassing. It's gonna be so embarrassing that I'm putting my headlamp on, but you gotta do what you gotta do, and I have to do it one-handed. I look like a tool, right? Let me turn the light off in my room because I don't know where they went. They must be afraid of the light. That one is Cinnamon. Cinnamon's a little scaredy pants. And the other one, oh, the other one's right here. The other one's name is Ice Cream. And they kind of like headbutt each other to get to the food, so I'll put some in a bowl. They're not the best at like sharing, so. And these are just like stray neighborhood cats. These did not come anywhere near me, but now they're not that afraid of me anymore. At least this one isn't. A little cat house that they go in sometimes. This is my backyard. Don't be afraid, Cinnamon. Come get your food. Alright, let me go back inside so I can get back to this praying mantis. Oh my god, speaking of praying mantis, how crazy is this? I have no idea how this got into my apartment. That is really, really weird. I'm a little freaked out, actually. I'm a little freaked out. That is very strange. Oh, Wait, let me turn on my light. I have no idea how this got in my apartment. Alright, I gotta figure out a way to get him. I don't want to just shoo him outside. Should I just shoo him outside? I feel like I need a box or something. My room's a mess. I don't know. I'll use this thank you card my mom got me for sending her birthday gift. Oh, I feel like it's kind of hurt. Oh, come on, buddy. I don't know if I can do this with one hand. Come on, buddy. There we go. Whoops. I don't think the cats will eat it, but I don't want it to be near the cats. Come on, buddy. There you go. I really don't want the cats to go in my apartment either. Go ahead, buddy. There you go. All right. It's good enough. Make sure there's no cats in my apartment. That would be crazy. Other than the cat that's supposed to be in my apartment. Which is... this little rascal. You can't come in. You can't come in, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, but you can't come in, baby. You can't come in, baby. I know, but you gotta go to bed. You can't come in. Move your paw. Thank you. Oh my God, that was really weird. That was really strange. Oh. Oh. Let me plug my phone back in. Actually, I don't know if the live video is still going on because my phone is like... okay, good. It's still going. Okay. Put the phone back on the tripod. Okay. Oh, let me turn this light off. I'd be too nervous to use him as a reference. I'm not, like, my next door neighbor, the little kid, is like, loves praying mantises. Grabbing them and, you know, holding them and stuff like that, but I don't know, I'm just like, I'm a little afraid to, I don't pick them up. They don't look this cute, unfortunately, in real life. Even, I know they won't hurt me, I guess, but I don't know, these things are, oops, These things are formidable. Okay, so let me get back to this eye real quick before I lose my captive audience. That was crazy though. That was so weird. I mean, I don't really have a lot of bugs in the apartment, and definitely not praying mantises. That's just very, very odd. Alright, so we'll do that. Give him a little bit of shadow. I originally didn't want this to be a super long video, but with comes down to wildlife, I guess you can't really, whatever happens, happens. Cats outside that need feeding. Praying mantis needs rescuing. I just like to give a lot of extra love to the eyes, because, you know, I don't know why I did that. They don't need shading on their eyes. Chris Connolly. My man, I haven't spoken to you for a while, man. Hope you're doing good. Thanks for checking out the video. That's crazy. First is a praying mantis manifests itself in my room, and then my old buddy, who I haven't spoken to in a long time, comes through. Let's give him some jazz real quick. Yeah, let's give him some jazz. I'll do a pinch lighter. I usually wouldn't do this until the end, but it's such a treat, you know? I just put some new brushes on my, oh, I have to put this on a new layer above. Do I like that eye glare? Man, these eyes are way out of whack. I don't know. I go back and forth with, like, the eye glare that I want to use. Because use some like funky. Could always do some like funky thing like this and then fade it out. Could do something like that. I don't know which one we like better. Or we could just do, oops. We could just do a glob. See, now I'm getting like, these are the things, this is what has me up all hours of the night, because little things like making an eye perfect, which doesn't really need to be perfect. You know what, we'll just go with that's not bad. We'll stick with that. Make sure they're level. Yeah, we'll stick with that. That looks good. And I'll just add a little bit of jazz over here. Just to give it some shape. Give it a little ice down here. I don't know what these words are I'm saying. I promise I don't normally call stuff this weird. Whatever these weird noises I'm making right now. Ice. Glaze. I don't ever call it that. I guess that's the beauty of going live, is you start talking nonsense. I'm a little freaked out still. I'm a little freaked out that, it feels like I set that up, but I mean, I don't know, how would I even set it up? I mean, you guys like watched me go outside and feed the cats and then come back inside and there's an actual praying mantis. That is just very, very odd, I think. Really going on out, all out on these eyeballs. I don't know what happened. I like it. I think that's cool. All right, let me polish off this body. All right, let's see here. So make this a little bigger. So I'm just going to keep this kind of like angular, because if I was trying to get the anatomy like perfect, then that would be a boring video because I'll be here all night. So I'm just going to keep it playful and somewhat fast. Wait, what are these? Okay, I thought they were like divots that I would have to draw, but it's just a color pattern. Right. Got that there. It's got another leg here. Let me make sure I get the legs right. Let me sort of clip in here. Kind of like a bee or a beetle. I mean, there's like three of them. Four of them here where he's gonna have two. All right, let's see. Something like that there. Let's see what his abs look like. So he's got something like that there. Oops, I guess it would go. His other leg is here. Right? I'm a bit confused. Where is his other leg? Oh, I know what I did. I cheated. So that's right. So he has two legs here, and then there's two legs back there. Okay, I'm back on track. Trying to figure out where this other leg came from. Oops. That sketch line was a nice, Nice line, actually. It gets a little bigger. It has a little I'll take that line. All right, and this is when okay, so it's sort of like here we go, that's not bad. I'll take that for now. Something like this. Just something to show like that it curves down. Alright, let me get this leg out of the way. So did you guys see my post from Instagram, or are you just on seeing this on YouTube? Because I posted a little thing on Instagram really quick just saying that I was going live. But I'm curious, like, I don't know how anyone would even see that I'm live on YouTube. Like, I don't even know how that works. Oh, you got a notification on YouTube. Interesting. That's cool. Alright, let me get this other part of his body. Well, I appreciate you, like, coming and checking me out. I really like this, this live. Because it's like, you know, I'd like to like make a video, but sometimes like I just want to doodle. So I figure, why not just doodle live. All right, let me just show a little bit of depth here. Nothing too crazy. You know, we'll color him in. Give him a little hue. A bit. Color in his little abdomen. Abdomen. Back leg. All right, let's see here. Okay, so here's some interesting patterns that we can mess around with. So let me just make this a little bigger, and then we'll go with, we'll just give him some, oops, it's a little too dark. What does he have on his arms? Oh, he has like a little bit. Does he have anything on his little butt? Not really. A little bit of color. give the leaves a little color too. I really don't need this. Oops. Cut that. Merge these eyeballies. You know what? I'll just merge them all. Bring this up. Shout out to on Instagram, Manti Bully. And yeah, that's my mantis. All right, thanks you guys for watching. I'm gonna make a little icon, and then I guess this video will go up on YouTube as well. But I appreciate you four, Anna. I appreciate your help in helping me figure this out. Chris Connolly, oh there he is. Matt Connolly, Merdan. Thank you guys, my boys, the Connolly bros. Appreciate it. Yeah, I'll see you guys soon. Thanks for watching.